10. Screen resolution. When you capture images in Power Automate Desktop, the stored images are affected by the computer's screen resolution and DPI scaling. Before using image recognition, ensure the DPI scaling stays the same among the screens. Otherwise, your flows will probably fail. To achieve this, you can use the Set Screen Resolution action to change the screen resolution of the target machines. The new resolution has to be the same as the source machines from which the image was captured. To find the resolution of the source machine, use the Get Screen Resolution action or check the Windows display settings. 9. Run SQL queries on Excel. Excel actions in Power Automate Desktop can handle most Excel automation scenarios. However, SQL queries can retrieve and manipulate significant amounts of Excel data more efficiently. Instead of using loops, conditionals, and multiple Excel actions, you can implement only two actions, the Open SQL Connection action and the Execute SQL Statement action. 8. Keyboard shortcuts. Many desktop applications provide keyboard shortcuts that make multi-step tasks easy and fast to perform. Power Automate Desktop allows you to apply these shortcuts to create shorter and less complicated flows. You can achieve this by using Send Keys. Before sending keystrokes to an application, however, make sure that you use Focus Window action to activate the window and make sure that you are sending the keystrokes to the correct application. 7. Identify a window. It's common in flow development to create flows that use several windows with the same title and class. Power Automate Desktop enables users to distinguish identical windows using handles. Handles are numbers that uniquely identify each window. To retrieve the handle of a window, launch the application with the Run Application action and set the After Application Launch drop-down menu to Wait for application to load. The handle is stored by default in the variable named Window Handle. 6. Extract text from Word. You can use OCR to extract text from Word documents, however, this approach can become complicated for multi-page documents that require scrolling. A more efficient way to extract text from Word documents is to use VBScript. Power Automate Desktop provides the Run VBScript action that enables you to run scripts on your desktop. 5. Navigate instead of clicking. If you want to save development steps and building actions that could fail if the layout of the navigation changes, instead of clicking through the menu of the web page and building all of the required actions, navigate directly to the link that you need to access. You can use the Go to Web Page action in Microsoft Power Automate Desktop to go back and forward and to navigate to new URLs. 4. Use message boxes. In attended automation, interaction between the user and the workstation is necessary. Therefore, you can use message boxes and dialogue to collect input from the user and create even better flows. For example, you can allow the user to upload a file with the action Display Select File dialog. You can collect free text from the user with Display Input dialog, and you can also display a message and ask the user for approval. To do this, use the simple Display Message. 3. Process Advisor. Having installed Microsoft Power Automate Desktop will allow you to use Process Advisor to record the processes you wish to analyze. The Process Advisor can surface insight about time-consuming processes across your organization. Ideally, the processes that demand the most manual time and resources should be automated. This is how it works. Step 1, you identify and create the process about which you want to gain insight. Step 2, you invite colleagues to collaborate and add new recordings. Step 3, you record the actions either you or your colleagues take to complete the process at hand. Step 4, you remove sensitive information, then group your actions into meaningful activities. Step 5, you generate a process map where you can analyze it and get insight. Key insight included how many people recorded the task, the average time it takes to complete the task, how many different paths the user took, and so on. 2. Evil robots. Robots can very easily hide malicious code that can do anything from changing machine settings and privileges to installing scripts and deleting files. There is currently no antivirus against robots or security measure except us. If we want to download or receive an automation, we should always make sure of how it works, but especially keep an eye out and a lookout for the following actions. Set service, set window environment variable, ping, run VBS script and any script, run DOS command, and run application. 1. Learn. Congratulations, RPA Champion, for making it to first place. I have shared my top 30 tips with you, a fellow automation enthusiast, and also that I like to call RPA Champion. In first place, I want to show you how you can exponentially become better at Power Automate, and this is by using the official Power Automate resources accessible from your Power Automate desktop under the Help in the settings. You will have access to the documentation, where you will find different guides, insight, ideas, and answers to many different questions you might have. There is also the learning library, and this is a set of tutorials that cover pretty much all aspects of the solutions and how to get started with the different components. There is also a community, which is very active, and if you're looking for to solve a specific issue, is the perfect place. There is also many webinars available on the Microsoft website, and I will be sharing different links for all of these resources that are not available already on Power Automate in the description below. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget, F subscribing, start automating.